Images are powerful. They inspire us to protest. They inspire us to aspiration. And that's why it's so important, and we had this great conversation. Raise your hand if you were at the film the other night with Robert Townsend and all those actors. Michael Clark Duncan, thank you. Thank you. You have a special charge, those of you who saw that film, and Jeff and I will be working on this, to enlist everybody else in this room and in the Youth and College Division to help make sure that the movie In the Hive is shown. My generation had a movie called Boys in the Hood. It really called the country to pay attention to the violence that was happening in our communities and killing so many of our young people. And then it just sort of left you there. This is a movie that deals with those same issues, sadly 20 years later, same problems, but really has much more of a message. And great actors like Michael Clark Duncan and Loretta Devine, a whole crop of new young actors, Robert Townsend, made it on a $1 million budget out of love for black young people. The movie had me in tears for hours. I don't cry much, I gotta tell you. I was sitting on a plane with my little computer in front of me, tears running down my face, looking kind of sheepish at folks, and you know, real men cry, it's okay, you know? And so, in our second century, it's not enough just to protest what we don't like. We have to create markets for what we do like. And we know that this movie is so moving that if it is seen, it will cause courageous conversations to happen that need to happen about the changes people need to make in their own lives and the changes that we need to make in society. And so I hope when you get that call, because it'll come over the summer and through the early fall, to write a letter to AMC or to any of the other distributors to make sure that this movie is shown, that you will join your sisters and brothers in the Youth and College Division and all of us in the NAACP nationally in saying, let In the Hive be shown, and most importantly, show movies that need to be seen. Movies that have a message as well as entertain. Don't just keep showing us the same bad representations of ourselves with no message other than we can expect to die young and live lives that are full of suffering.
So I've never been prouder than I have been of this Youth and College Division. I just want to say thank you for the work that our Youth and College Division and our national board members do. It's 75 years of speaking truth to power. Young people, we stand on your shoulders. And it's not, you are not the leaders of tomorrow. You are the leaders of what? Right now. You are the leaders of right now. And I'm going to give you a test right now. Because courage. Hey, thank you and God bless you. Give me an N. Give me an A. Give me an A. Give me a C. Give me a P. What does it spell? Woo, woo. You've got to fight if you want to be free. You've got to give it. Woo, woo. Hey, NAACP, I'm counting on you. Can I count on you? Are you going to be there with me? Yes, NAACP. Congratulations, Youth and College Division. I love you. I love you, and thank you, and God bless you. Peace.
For the last 10 years, she has been a culture and entertainment journalist writing for The Village Voice, Essence, Vibe, King, and Source magazines. Currently, she is the editorial director of theloop21.com, which focuses on political, culture, and entertainment from a hip perspective. Prior to joining the Loop 21, she served as a managing editor and social media manager for Vibe magazine and website. Please give a round of applause to Chloe Hilliard. Next, we have a brother who is nationally recognized hip-hop organizer, journalist, activist, and scholar. He has organized hip-hop town hall meetings and used the power and agency of hip-hop to inform, mobilize, and motivate young people to participate in all aspects of civic life. A native of Milwaukee, Wisconsin, and a PhD candidate at UCLA, he currently serves as the executive director of the League of Young Voters. Please give a round of applause to Biko, better known as Robert Biko Baker. And last but certainly not least, she's a producer, media strategist, and currently serves as the Director of Media Strategy and Content Development for the American Values Institute, a think tank dedicated to race, media, and policy. Passionate about using media as a mechanism to create social awareness, she brings a unique spectrum of experience, not only in television production, but also in strategic communications and public affairs. Additionally, she is the founder and executive director of Project SET, a nonprofit media arts organization dedicated to educating youth about the power and influence of media and its effects on our perceptions and behavior. Please welcome and give a round of applause to Alicia Cowan-Vieira.
Thank you all for being a part of this panel. And I want us to, I know it's late, especially for folks that are used to being on the East Coast and just flew in. So we're gonna try to keep the energy kind of high here. You all, we exist in a 24-hour media cycle that is putting out images constantly, whether it's on television, online, through radio, through mobile devices. What is the real effect? And Alicia, we'll start with you and come back this way. What is the real effect that you see, this one, the 24-hour cycle of media, and two, the kind of media that's being pumped out affecting young people in our community?
Well, I think we have to understand that media is extremely powerful, and that's a great thing, and it's a dangerous thing, especially living in a 24-hour media cycle, news cycle, everywhere you go. Media impacts everything you do, your perception of self, how you see the world around you, the choices and why you buy things, your health, your interpersonal relationships. And I think it's crucial, especially for young people, to understand what's happening. The work I do, I actually, Jeff mentioned, I've been a producer for 8 years working in various capacities in mainstream media. I started out actually in news at ABC News. I went on to MTV and worked in their pro-social department. I also worked at CNN all through the election. And before working at the American Values Institute, I was at Harpo launching the Dr. Oz show. So I've been in various capacities, sometimes intentionally doing work that was about creating positive images, other times, strictly from a reporting perspective. And just my experience there, I just know that it's crucial that people understand the people who are behind the scenes and disseminating this information to you. Oftentimes, there are very smart people, but too often there's people who don't have our interests, and particularly young people's interests, in mind in the messages that they're disseminating. So I charge you guys to be critical media consumers, and in doing so by asking questions when you are consuming all this media around you. Trying to figure out who is actually behind this media and why they are creating these messages. What's the audience that they're talking about? We just saw a video. What did they leave out? It's really important that you take a critical eye and analyze it so you can understand what's happening to you. The work we're doing now, even at the American Values Institute, is so much about unconscious and conscious bias and perceptions. And you need to understand too that 98% of the decisions that you're making and you're getting your point of view is actually a result of your unconscious. So things are happening to you and you don't even understand why they're happening. And with media disseminating so many messages, it's crucial that you analyze that and understand why people are doing what they're doing. And I'll leave that at that for now.
How y'all doing? Oh, how y'all doing? All right, I thought it was you, Kyle's division. All right. I want you to look to your neighbor, and my phone is ringing, that's terrible. I want you to look to your neighbor and say, I am not a minority. Look to your other neighbor and say, I'm not a minority. I get my name from a man by the name of Steve Biko, who was a South African revolutionary, and he had this quote. He said, the most powerful tool in the hands of the oppressed is the mind of, the most powerful tool in the hands of the oppressor is the mind of the oppressed. Right, when we turn on the news, and that clip was perfect, all we see is young black people being criminals and thugs. And I was at a panel yesterday, and powerful young people from y'all organization stood up and said they wanted to be in the future. And I think what ends up happening is media, we get tricked into believing the stereotypes and the message that we see on TV. We get tricked into believing that we're criminals and thugs. And what ends up happening in this environment, we are media creators, we end up creating that on that story. But if I, how many of y'all watch, go to worldstarhiphop.com? Keep it real. All right, that's about half of the room. We end up perpetrating our own demise by filming ourselves and putting up on WorldStar. There was a clip at Howard a couple weeks ago where young people, most brilliant black minds in the country go to Howard, filming themselves fighting each other like gang members on the street. And I think it's up to y'all to create a new message and a new discourse and a new message. And we can't do this if we're not going to celebrate our gifts and our talents. If you are a smart kid and you haven't been in the streets and you're not in the streets, you need to pat yourself and give yourself a round of applause. Give yourself a round of applause. Because that's the message that's going to inspire the next generation to stand up and do something.
Hello, everyone. My name is Chloe Hilliard. I have been a journalist since I was 18 years old. I'm not 18 year old now, but I've been doing it for a number of years. And the great thing about working in journalism, I did it because I wanted to tell people's stories. I wanted to give a voice to the voiceless. I wanted to be an activist. And the way that I could be an activist was to get a pen and paper, in the olden days, a pen and paper, and write people's stories down. Now, if you have a cell phone, a computer, you can be a journalist. Simple as that. You don't have to be the best journalist, but you can report on an incident, on a crime, on a matter that is important in your local community and get it out to masses that you might have never had the opportunity to do before. So a lot of times people look at the media and say, oh, it's the media's fault because they only show us X, Y, and Z. Yeah, that is true, but now you have a learning curve. You have a platform to correct that story. So if kids in that community in Chicago wanted to take it to the internet, they can say, you know what, this isn't the truth. And here are people in our community, and here's what we have to say. So a lot of times now, it's really easy to blame the media, and the media definitely is at fault when it comes to a lot of things, but now there's a chance for you to voice your opinion and your truth, and you have to really utilize that and take advantage of that.
Let me. I had a long conversation today with a couple of people who were responding to a magazine cover.
What magazine cover?
This certain magazine. And there's this sister who has lately been talking about motivating people. Right. But it's not motivation for school. It's not motivation for entrepreneurship. Mm-hmm. Not motivation for social justice. It's motivating me so I don't feel my legs.
Yeah.
And then on the cover of this magazine, she, for people that didn't get it, Kelly Rowland. some people, it's just never going to happen.
Yeah.
But on the magazine, on the cover of Vibe, mm-hmm. she is on the cover naked with her hands covering her breasts. Mm-hmm. Now, for a lot of people, this was not the brand image of Kelly Rowland 2 years ago, a year ago, 6 months ago. And now, as a result of one, this song, which is sexually, at least, I wouldn't say it's not really sexually explicit, but it is suggestive.
Yeah.
And the imagery is suggestive, and the movements are suggestive. And then the follow-up to this with this kind of magazine cover says a couple of things to people. It says, I can't really hit big unless I go this route.
Mm-hmm.
Is that an over-exaggeration, one, for us to think that way? And Chloe, I want you to talk about this first. Is it an over-exaggeration for us to say, look at Kelly Rowland's song, look at her now showing herself in a way that she may not have just a year ago, mm-hmm. and a level of commercial success that she's never had up until this point in time? Are we being overly sensitive by critiquing that, or are we really seeing this young woman who has the potential of being a role model mm-hmm. for having a level of class now ruining that?
Mm-hmm.
What do you think?